gonna start with the AL, starting with the West, then the Central, then the East, then move to the NL. So, at the top of the AL West, no surprise to anybody. Actually, let's bold these. Let's bold those, that looks better. No surprise to anybody, the Houston Astros receive. Second place, we have a tie. Three of the writers say that the Seattle Mariners are going to come in second, and three of the writers say that the Los Angeles Angels will come in second. So we have our very first tie and our first tiebreaker. I'm gonna maybe be a bit of a homer here, but I do actually think, even if I wasn't a homer, I think the Mariners probably manage second here. So, second in the AL West, I'm going to say, belongs to the Seattle Mariners on my hat right here. Now, this is where it gets tricky, because in third place, you had three of the writers saying that the Angels would get third. Three of the writers said the Angels would get second. Two of them said they would get third. And one of them said they would get fourth. So in the aggregate, that means that the Angels, they are predicting, will be third in the AL West. Have also looked really good. They've looked really good, and I could, they've made some off-season acquisitions and things like that, and the Angels have so many problems. The Angels have all the talent in the world, Ohtani and Trout, that they should be good, but it all comes back to the franchise management, the front office, Arte Moreno. It was looking like he was going to sell the team. Now he's declining to sell the team, so he's still going to be around, and some of those franchise level issues can sink a team. But although I think the Rangers probably could manage third, I'm going to put them at fourth here, just because this is the consensus of the sports writers. But me personally, I could see the Rangers coming in third, pushing the Angels down to fourth. But then everyone agrees on this, no surprise to anybody at all. The Oakland Athletics. The Oakland Athletics are predicted to come last by every single sports writer, 6 out of 6. Just like the Astros being at 1, they all agree the Athletics will be in last. You have to feel bad for Oakland fans at this point. Just a really tough go of things for them lately. They don't even know if they're going to get a stadium. I don't know what the stadium talks have been like recently. I don't know if there's been any progress, but it's just a bad situation overall. Now we come to the AL Central, and I have another tiebreaker to break. The writers are split on 1 and 2. Three of the 6 writers have the Guardians coming in first, and 3 of the 6 writers have the Guardians coming in second. 3 of the 6 writers have the Twins coming in first, and 3 of the 6 writers have the Twins coming in second. So I have to do a tiebreaker between who I think will come in first between the Guardians and the Twins. And I'm gonna say come in first. was like good. We have a good red for them. Maybe like a darker red. There we go. The Guardians, which means that I'm predicting that the Twins will come in second in the AL Central. Kansas City coming in last, and then five out of the six have the Detroit Tigers. The Tigers taking the final spot. This may be a better orange here. Yeah, it looks a little bit better for the Astros as well. Maybe the Tigers need lighter orange. There we go. They have the Tigers coming in last of the AL Central, and I'm not confident I'm in any position to disagree with that. Okay. Now finally we move to our last American League team. The American League East, American League I should say. Wow, this one gets a little bit tricky, but this is the most popular division, the American League. You know, the East Coast, that's where most of your fans are. Things like that. And again, I have to settle a tie. They have 3 votes of 6 for the Yankees in first, and 3 votes of 6 for the Blue Jays in first. Kind of like last time, and the other 3 of Blue Jays in second, and there are 3 of the Yankees in second. So I have to decide between the Blue Jays or the Yankees taking the AL East. Chase really elevated the Yankees season last year, but that's behind us now. Like I really struggle to think that he'll repeat that sort of performance again this season, but I mean, I don't know if the Yankees are the Yankees, but I'm gonna predict the Blue Jays, which means the Yankees will be coming in second in the American League East. Now in the 3 spot, you have 3 of the 6 writers predicting that the Tampa Bay Rays will take 3rd. 2 of the 6 predicting that the Red Sox will take 3rd. And 1 of the 6 predicting that the Orioles will take 3rd. I'm actually going to go completely off script here. I'm going to throw in my own opinion. I'm going to say the Orioles take 3rd. I don't know why. I just kind of have a gut Nationals, I think they'll take third, which means you're giving me the Rays in fourth, right? And you're giving me the Red Sox coming in last in the division, which I think they also did last season. But I don't know, like I said, I just kind of have a feeling about the Orioles this year. They were up-and-coming team last season, really exciting team last season. And I think they'll take a step. Now, Tampa's also really good, but I don't know. This is just my prediction, and again, I'm not a huge baseball person. You know, I'm a very casual baseball fan, but that's just what I think. All right, now for the National League. The National League. It seems like everybody is pretty much in agreement here, which makes this really easy for me. Everybody, and I mean everybody, all six writers are predicting that the Padres will be winning the National League West. And in second place, you have the Los Angeles Dodgers. Yes, 6 out of 6 on both of those for the Padres and the Dodgers predictions. 6 out of 6. So that's as good as you're gonna get. Now you have some deflections here, but 4 out of the 6 riders at the Arizona Diamondbacks coming third, with 2 of the 6 having the Giants coming third. So we're putting the Diamondbacks here in third. And you're going to give me that nice kind of dark red for the Diamondbacks. There we go. And then 4 out of the 6 riders think that the San Francisco Giants are going to be your fourth place team in the NL West, and they are all in agreement, 6 out of 6, that the losers, the bottom team of the NL West, will be the Colorado Rockies. And I can't say that I have any disagreement with that. The Rockies are extremely dysfunctional. Extremely dysfunctional as an organization. Okay, now we're going to come to the National League Central. 5 out of your 6 writers, 5 out of 6, predicted the winners of the National League Central will be the St. Louis Cardinals. And I can't say that I disagree with that. They were pretty good last season. Especially you had the really nice storyline with Pujols and all that. But Cardinals are just a good, solid team. 1 of the 6 is the Brewers coming in first. And then 3 out of the 6 of the Brewers coming in second. So on the aggregate of those votes, I'm going to put the Brewers here, second in the NL Central. We'll give them this kind of gold color there. That looks good. Milwaukee Brewers. 2 of the 6 riders at the Chicago Cubs coming in second, and then 4 of the 6 of them coming in third. So we're putting the Cubs here at 3. Which is really unfortunate, because I love Seiya Suzuki. I really wanted him to come to Seattle, and he ended up going to the Cubs instead. And I think he had a pretty good season in Chicago last year, and I'd like to see them do a little bit more, a little bit better. In fourth place, 5 out of the 6 voters have Pittsburgh coming second to last in the division. Which I can't disagree with. Pittsburgh always been a team I like, but they just just always struggle, especially recently, just bad ownership, cheap ownership. But they, thankfully, they're not the worst team in their division because they have the Cincinnati Reds sharing a division with them, who are, you know, not great, not great whatsoever. So, that's the NL Central. Now we're going to get to the NL East. Four out of the six riders are giving the winners of the East to the New York Mets. The New York Metropolitans. Big money splashing team. Lots of cash being thrown around that team. Squad. They were meant to be like the team to beat last season. They kind of fizzled out, but they're predicting they're going to win the NL East. And coming in second place in the NL East with three of the six votes, but they got two of the first place votes, so on aggregate, they take the two, is the Atlanta Braves. The Atlanta Braves. Six for the Braves in second, one vote for the Mets, and two votes for the Phillies in second. But then we get to third, and the Philadelphia Phillies get four of the six votes for third overall. The Braves get one vote for third, and the Mets get one vote for third. But on aggregate scoring in this prediction, Philadelphia Phillies get third in the NL East. However, the riders are in complete and total agreement about 4 and 5. All six of them agree with these rankings. The Marlins coming in fourth, and the Washington Nationals in sixth at the bottom of the division. So, using the scores of those six baseball writers plus a little bit of tie-breaking on my behalf and one changing of their opinion, where I interjected my own opinion, this is the season predictions as it stands now at opening day. Time I post this video is the first day of games will have already happened. At this point, the only game that's happened is the Yankees game as of when I'm recording this video, but we'll see what happens day one here. I'm really excited to be able to watch the Mariners again, but these predictions as they stand in the AL West, we have the Astros, Mariners, Angels, Rangers, and Athletics. In the AL Central, we have the Guardians, Twins, White Sox, Royals, and Tigers. In the AL East, we have the Blue Jays, Yankees, Orioles, Rays, and Red Sox. In the NL West, we have the Padres, Dodgers, Diamondbacks, Giants, and Rockies. In the NL Central, we have the Cardinals, Brewers, Cubs, Pirates, and Reds. And in the NL East, we have the Mets, Braves, Phillies, Marlins, and Nationals. So, let me know what you guys think about these predictions, if you agree with them, if you disagree. You're looking forward to seeing this MLB season. If you're excited for it, what expectations you have for your favorite team, I'd love to hear your comments down below.